Shalom, shalom. This is the brother of Baal. You're back here once again. Before I get started, like always, I want to give all praises and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rechach Kodash. Double honors to my teachers, the elder apostles of Great Millstone, and shalom to the whole full elect. Yeah, in light of the certain topic of the week, dealing with unity, being on one accord, I want to play this video. I want to start off this lesson by playing this video. And it comes from one of my favorite movies growing up, Drumline. The title, the person titled this video, One Band, One Sound, The Essence of Teamwork. So I'm going to play this video and then I'm going to go into why I played this video. Well, I'm going to play a part of this video.
Teamwork. And if you wish to remain here, you better start believing in being on time. You. Who is your roommate?
Devin. Miles. Sir.
Eyes front!
What's up, Dr. Lee?
It's all good, Mr. Miles. Glad to have you here.
Thank you, sir.
Why was he late?
I guess he overslept.
Well, why didn't you wake him?
I'm not his mother, sir.
I asked Mr. Miles why his roommate was late. He says he guesses he overslept. I asked why didn't you wake him, and he says he is not his mother. Section leaders, what is our concept?
One band, one sound.
One band, one sound. When one of us is late, we are all late. When one of us looks or sounds bad, we all look and sound bad. So what's the concept?
One band, one sound.
Now I want 10 laps from all those who are not their roommate's mama.
All right, now when you go into this clip that I just played, this guy Miles, he was a very talented drummer, and he thought he was, you know, special, more special than anybody else that was part of the drum line. So as you can even see in this clip, like, everybody else is wearing white, and he comes out, you know, wearing all black, and then the head coordinator asks him, you know, why didn't you wake your roommate, you know? Where's your roommate? Why didn't you wake him? He said, I'm not his mother. You know, and that's the mindset of a lot of these guys in these other camps. They feel like, you know, unity means, you know, as long as we on the same team, then that's all that matters. As long as we're Hebrew Israelites, then we're unified. All right. If anybody that plays sports, like I played sports growing up, you know, when you're on a team, and even when you look at professional sports, everybody's on a team, but everybody doesn't win. Everybody's not considered a great team. The great teams have unity, all right? Just because you're on a team don't mean you have unity. Just because you're a Hebrew Israelite don't mean we're supposed to be unified, right? Like, when I used to play sports, the players that came together and learned the plays, all right, and did the plays like they were scripted to be done and executed the plays like they were supposed to be executed, they more chance than none, they had a majority chance of winning the game, right? They weren't guys that came game day, they wanted to show their own skills and went off the playbook and didn't, you know, do the play according to how it was written. They didn't have that mindset, all right? They understood, for the betterment of the team, I'm going to play my role. If I'm a shooter and on this play, I need to be on the corner, I'm going to be in the corner. If I'm a big man, even though I can dribble, if I'm a big man, they need me down in the post for this play, I'm going to be in the post for the betterment of the team, for us to win, right? That's what unity leads towards, and that's why this guy says one band, one sound. You know, if one of us is late, we're all late. If one of us look bad, we all look bad. And that's the fabric that's built into the culture of GMS that we've learned from our elder apostles, all right, of Great Millstone. You know, that's why us heads that's under them, that's been, set up over these different regional camps, we teach that same culture, all right? If one of us is late, we're all late. If one of us look bad, we all look bad, you know? You pick your brother up, you know, we're in this together, we're unified, and, you know, part of unity is teaching the same thing. That's why I use this clip as a band, because the scriptures speak about us singing the same song, all right? And then, you know, with all these different camps, a lot of these camps are singing different songs, all right? They have different doctrines. There can come no unity from that, right? And that's why I pulled up this word unity in the etymology. And of course, I'm gonna get the scriptures also, but so I pulled up this word unity in the etymology, right? And it says oneness, sameness, and agreement, right? That's the word I want to focus on in the etymology, agreement. You got certain camps that say the mark of the beast is spiritual, the mark of the beast is Christianity, the mark of the beast is so forth and so on. And you have us that teach that the mark of the beast is the RFID microchip, right? Well, how can we be unified with a camp that's teaching opposite when you have to be in agreement, all right? In doctrine, you have to be in agreement in the teachings to be unified, right? All right, one band, one sound. But see, even with this guy Miles said, I'm not his mama. Well, that's the mindset that some of these camp leaders have, and these other guys in these other camps have. Well, I don't need to tell them that they need to change their doctrine. They don't have to teach the same mark of the beast breakdown I teach. They're an Israelite. That's the same mindset that this guy Miles had in this movie. I'm not his mama. We both on the drum line, shit. You know, and that's that. They just love him because he's an Israelite. You know, who cares, you know, if he got an edge up? Who cares if he shows up late? Who cares if he's lukewarm? Who cares if he's always drunk? And who cares if he, you know, as long as he's an Israelite, love him and be unified with him. Who cares what he do? Who cares what he does? Let him do it. Let him do him. Let him be him. Don't uphold him to any standard. Just let him be him. He's an Israelite. Let's be unified together. That's not unity. That's disorder. That's chaos. That's confusion. Right? And a lot of these guys are gonna learn that the hard way. The first precept I want to get is Ephesians, the first chapter. Ephesians, the fourth chapter. I think I said first. But Ephesians, the fourth chapter. And I want to go down to verse... let me see. Once this loads. Right? So we have here Ephesians chapter 4. And let's start at 13, right? Or we could start at 12. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 12. It says, for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Yahusha HaMashiach, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of the Most High Yahweh, unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Yahusha HaMashiach, that we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine. Yeah, you can't be changing the doctrine. You can't have different doctrines. Can't be tossed to and fro every time you hear something different. We all have to be rooted in the same doctrine, right? Unity, that's what unity is. In agreement. It says, by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Yahusha HaMashiach, from whom the whole body fitly joined together, fitly, right? We all fit like puzzles in a piece, right? You want to fit the puzzles on a puzzle piece, a whole puzzle. You want the puzzle pieces to fit. Well, if it ain't gonna fit, if it's a different image, if it's one puzzle piece that goes to a different puzzle, and you try to put it in a whole different puzzle, that puzzle piece in a whole different puzzle, it ain't gonna fit because it's a different image on it, right? It's a different shape. Well, that's ultimately what y'all teaching when y'all teaching a different doctrine of the mark of the beast, and you know, you keep the law, and you can get shape ups. Well, that's a different image that you're speaking of also in a way, all right? All right, you're speaking up a made-up image instead of the image of Yahweh Shem Yahushua. All right, the true doctrine, the true word, all right? It says, fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplieth, all right? Compacted, right? When something's fit and compacted, that means it's perfectly fit together. You got all these different camps with these different doctrines. That's not perfectly fit, all right? That's all different type of shapes and sizes, man. It says, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. And yes, we're all going to have different type of spirits and personalities, but in doctrine, we have to be the same. We have to be the same in doctrine, because there's only one true doctrine, and that's the doctrine of Yahweh Bahasham Yahusha. All right, there's not a million different breakdowns. There's not a million different doctrines. Yeah, so, you know, going back to this video, the essence of teamwork. You know, and this lesson doesn't have to be long. You know, you got these guys that complicate the, they try to complicate the simplicity that's within Yahweh Bahashem Yahusha. But the apostles throughout the letters, namely Paul, taught us time and time again the type of unity that we need, all right? The reason why those letters was established or written in the first place was to establish unity, all right? Oh, my connection. Bear me one second. Yeah, I had to get my connection straight real quick. So it's, let's read this real quick, man. And then I'm going to wrap it up. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 10, right? It says, Now beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord, Yahusha HaMashiach, that ye all speak the same thing, and that there be no divisions among you, but that ye be perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment, right? So it was one band, one sound. One of us look bad, we all look bad, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, you got to have that spiritual eye to see, you know, what Paul is talking about, you know what I'm saying? You can't just accept every brother just because you say he's an Israelite, so he's accepted flaws and all. He don't have to change at all. Everybody just come into camps as you are, be how you want to be, do what you want to do. As long as you're Israelite, that's how we're going to get out of slavery. Hell no. The Lord's coming back to deliver his elect. All right, that's speaking the same thing, that's speaking that same song. All right, so I want to do a quick lesson on that. Hopefully this was edifying. Until the next time, I say shalom.